In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Coming together as God's family with confidence, let us ask the Father's forgiveness, for he is full of gentleness and compassion. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who by the grace of the Holy Spirit have filled the hearts of your faithful with gifts of charity, grant health of mind and body to your servants, for whom we beseech your mercy, that they may love you with all their strength and with all their love, do what is pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, in Christ we were also chosen, destined in accord with the purpose of the one who accomplishes all things according to the intention of his will, so that we might exist for the praise of his glory. We who first hoped in Christ. In him, you also, who have heard the word of truth, the gospel of our salvation, and have believed in him, were sealed with the promised Holy Spirit, which is the first fulfillment of our inheritance towards the redemption as God's possession to the praise of his glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial song. Bless the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Bless the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Exalt you just in the Lord. Praise from the upright is fitting. Give thanks to the Lord on the harp. With the 10-string lyre, chant his praises.
Bless the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
For upright is the word of the Lord, and all his works are trustworthy. He loves justice and right. Of the kindness of the Lord, the earth is full.
Bless the people of the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Bless the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. From heaven, the Lord looks down. He sees all mankind.
Bless the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Jesus began to speak first to his disciples, Beware of leaven, that is, the hypocrisy of the Pharisees. There is nothing concealed that will not be revealed, nor secret that will not be known. Therefore, whatever you have said in the darkness will be heard in the light, and whatever you have whispered behind closed doors will be proclaimed on the housetops. I tell you, my friends, do not be afraid of those who kill the body, but after that can do no more. I shall show you whom you fear. Be afraid of the one who, after killing, has the power to cast into Gehenna. Yes, I tell you, be afraid of that one. Are not five sparrows sold for two small coins? Yet not one of them has escaped the notice of God. Even the hairs of your head have all been counted. Do not be afraid. You are worth more than many sparrows. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There are two things in today's readings that call my attention. And one of them gave me a lot of hope and joy. The other one kind of scared me. The first one is the scary one, comes from the gospel actually. Because Jesus is telling the disciples first that every secret will come out in the light. And that can be very scary. When everything that you said behind doors will be known. And sometimes we say many things behind doors that are not common, or that are not necessarily according to the gospel. But Jesus is not talking about that. He's talking about the good news of the gospel. Because at the time that the gospel was written, people were hiding to talk about Jesus, to give each other the good news of the gospel. That is why after that he said, don't be afraid. Rather be afraid of the one who can condemn you to Gehenna, that is, to the place of punishment. But don't be afraid even now. If you are faithful to the gospel, God will bless. For he cares for every creature. How much more he will care for you. The one thing that gave me joy was that part as well. But from the first reading, the part that St. Paul is telling to the Ephesians, where he says that we were chosen in Christ to give praise to God. In the context of the letter, Paul continues to exhort the people to the Ephesians not to fall into the temptation to become Jews in order to become Christians. He says, you already are chosen by Christ, in Christ, to praise God. And that's your only job. Praising God through your own lives, which is pretty much the same that Jesus is telling us in the gospel. What we say, what we do, whether in secret or not, if he praises God, that's our job. So the question came up for me, and I place it for you. How do you praise God with your life? Do you give praise to God in everything that happened to you? And I know a lot of things are not nice things that happen to us. In fact, they are very painful things. But do you still praise God through that? You might say, well, it's not easy. very Holy Spirit that wants to communicate with an all-holy, mighty God. And it's in us. Do we allow that Spirit to communicate with God? I think we do. Even when we cry, even when we are in pain, if we remember that God is there for us, is that already a praising moment? And today we come to celebrate precisely that at the Eucharist, praising God through the sacrifice of Jesus Christ and through his resurrection through the Eucharist. So let us ask God to strengthen our faith, to help us always remember who we are, how much God loves us, and how can we praise him for we were called to do that. And now let us pray. First, for our Holy Father, the Pope, for all bishops, for those who preach the gospel throughout the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our government leaders and leaders who work for justice and peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all members of our parish community, especially those who are going through difficult times, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are struggling through this pandemic, especially those who are ill or lost loved ones, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For today's special intention, we pray for Jerry O'Connor and for Pauline Campbell, who passed away this week. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Feel free to add one.
For all the sacrileges committed in places of worship, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for 4-year-old Braden Ahern, who is suffering from a tumor in his stomach, cancerous tumor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer. Fill to the earth the bread of human hands, so that we come for us, so the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fill to the body the bread of human hands, so that we come our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray that these our sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your name. The praise and glory of his name, our living and all his holy church.
Have mercy, O Lord, on your servants, for whom we offer your majesty the sacrifice of praise, that through these holy gifts they may obtain the grace of heavenly blessing and the glory of eternal happiness. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up your heart to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is only right and just, a duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you a thanks, O Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is such your gift, Since our praises are not due to your greatness, but promises us for salvation through Christ our Lord, and so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim,
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them that they do fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time of the betrayal and the will of it for his passion, bread and given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, Moses was it that he took the chalice. Once more given thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be brought for you and for many for their forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation. Give thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Help me, we pray, that by taking of the body of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remembering the Church is spread throughout the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and William our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Apostles, all the saints who have pleased her through all the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs of eternal life. And may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, of glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
In confidence, let us call upon our God of Jesus Christ.
Our Father, who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and gracious to grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, may be always free from sin, and save from all distress as we are with the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you take your apostles, peace I give you, and peace I give you. Look not at our sins from the faith of the Church, in grace to grant her peace and unity, and according to the will. Will you reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other a sign of peace.
Love of God.
This is Jesus Christ, the Lamb of God. takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his heart.
Spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most blessed sacrament. I love you above all things and desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
We ask the Lord, as we receive the divine mysteries, grant your servants to whom you have given a love for us, pardon for sins, consolation in this life, and unfailing guidance, that all of us united in your service May we rejoice together before your face, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Pray to St. Michael.
St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God relieve you in common prayer. And do thou, O Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, thrust into the dust Satan, and lower the evil spirits, who cry out the world, speaking to the souls. Amen.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us